Hey, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we are going to be solving linear inequalities from word problems. Let's do it. Our question says, Michael has 8 stickers. If he buys 12 stickers every day, at least how many days does he need to collect 100 stickers? So we need to write a linear equation with an inequality sign. So we know Michael has 8 stickers, so we can write 8. And we know the rate if he buys 12 stickers every day. So our rate is 12, and he buys one every day, so we can say times the number of days D. So if he has 8, he's getting 12 more every day. How many days does he need to collect 100 stickers? So we need him to have greater or equal to 100 stickers. And now we need to solve this equation for D. So we're going to subtract 8 from both sides. So we go -8 over here. So this gives us 12D is greater than or equal to 100 minus 8 is 92. Now we're going to divide 12 by both sides. So we divide by 12 over here. We divide by 12 over here. So we have D is greater than or equal to. And 92 divided by 12, that's equal to 7.6. But we need more than this. So D is going to have to be greater than or equal to 8 days. And there you are. Nice work. Let's try another one. So this one says, Amelia walks an average speed of 4 miles per hour. She has already walked 11 miles. After how many additional hours will she have walked more than 30 miles? So we know Amelia has walked 11 miles. So 11. And we have her rate at an average speed of 4 miles an hour. So plus 4 miles an hour times the number of hours. Will she have walked more than 30 miles? So this has to be greater than 30 miles. And now we need to solve this for H, the number of hours. So the first thing we do is subtract 11 from both sides. So we get 4H is greater than 30 minus 11 is 19. And then we have to divide both sides by 4 to get that H by itself. So now we have H is greater than 19 over 4. 19 over 4 is equal to 4.75. So if we need more than 30, H, the number of hours, is going to have to be 5 or more. Right there. Nice work. Let's do one more together. This one says, a carpenter charges $15 plus $30 for every additional hour of work. What is the maximum number of hours that the carpenter can be hired for $100? So we know that the carpenter charges $15 just right off the bat, plus 30 hours for every additional hour of work. So 30 times the number of hours is his total paycheck. But we only want to pay him $100. So the maximum we can pay is $100. So this has to be less than or equal to 100. Now we need to solve here for the H. So we subtract 15 from both sides. We get 30. H is less than or equal to 100 minus 15 is 85. I want to get that H by itself. We're dividing both sides by 30. So the number of hours is less than or equal to 85 divided by 30 is equal to 2.8. But we want to pay him less than $100. So the number of hours is less than or equal to 2. Right there. Nice work. So now you are going to practice these on your own. The most important part is setting up that initial linear inequality function. And you're going to do that by writing what you're starting with, what the rate is, and the total. And you need to make sure you know what direction this inequality sign goes, if it's a maximum or at least or more than, and determine the right inequality sign. So keep practicing with the games and quizzes, have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.